On November 6th of 2025, the alert level was raised at the stratovolcano, which comprises the tallest section of the Azores Island of Terceira, rising from V2 to V3. Fresh magma had been recently confirmed at 2 miles depth below sea level in October, and throughout the remainder of the month, the number of volcanic earthquakes further increased. Then, on the same day that Santa Barbara's alert level was raised to V3, almost right on cue, two of the largest volcanic earthquakes struck since unrest began in early 2021. These two earthquakes registered in as magnitudes 3.9 and 3.7, occurring within 45 seconds of each other, and were too small to cause any damage. Nevertheless, multiple residents on the island felt these two minor seismic events. However, this ongoing unrest episode, which has involved earthquake swarms and minor ground deformation, is not particularly special. The magma is seemingly moving at a very slow rate, and in fact, 10 other somewhat similar episodes of unrest have occurred at the Terceira volcano in historical times. Of these 10 intrusions, only 3 produced volcanic eruptions, of which 2 completely occurred at submarine vents offshore to the west of the island. For reference, the entire island of Terceira is a singular volcano, but the local volcano monitoring agencies subdivide this one volcano into 3 areas, which each are assigned a distinct alert level. Each of these areas occur on a specific fissure that runs through and offshore of both sides of the island. We have the Serreta submarine ridge, which exclusively produces submarine eruptions and last erupted in 2000, the towering central Santa Barbara stratovolcano, which last erupted in 1400, and the Terceira fissural volcanic system, which last erupted in 1761. This is my interpretation of what each level on the V0 to V6 alert level scale means. And now, here are each of the current alert levels in these 3 areas. The section whose alert level was just raised was the Santa Barbara stratovolcano. The best way to portray the current volcanic unrest this volcano has been undergoing involves the number of monthly earthquakes that have been produced. Normally, 0 earthquakes would strike Terceira's volcano every month, but in March 2021, an elevated rate of earthquakes began striking underneath Santa Barbara's summit. This then further increased over time, reaching more than 5, then 10, and then 20 quakes a month. By March 2024, monthly seismic events reached above 50 quakes a month for a time, resulting in Santa Barbara's alert level being raised from V2 to V3 in June of that year. Thereafter, seismic activity declined, almost appearing as if the volcanic unrest was nearly over, until the decline reversed during June 2025, which has continued ever since. Since earthquakes once again are on pace for November 2025 to reach the same rate as during the last time Santa Barbara's alert level was at V3 during 2024, its alert level was raised to that same level. There currently are not any other specific reasons why its alert level was raised. After all, the number of earthquakes that occurs has a link to underlying magma movement, which is powering the overall unrest. While this could be quite wrong, here is my model for Terceira's ongoing unrest since the beginning of 2021. A deep intrusion of magma occurred, eventually reaching the bottom of Santa Barbara's magma chamber. This chamber thereafter began to fill, with magma eventually also intruding westwards into the plumbing associated with part of the Serreta submarine ridge area. That magma ceased moving westwards with all the fresh molten rock then building in the main magma chamber, and then all of this would begin to cool. A new batch of magma then begins splitting in 2 directions at the bottom of the magma chamber, with a volume of magma intruding into the plumbing associated with the very westernmost section of Terceira's fissural volcanic system. By October 2025, magma ascended at 2 miles below sea level, with magma having taken 17 months to ascend 2 kilometers. Since then, it seems that the aforementioned eastward-heading magma supply weakened, with new molten rock being largely sent upwards into Santa Barbara's magma chamber. This generated an increased number of earthquakes as of November 2025. Despite all of this, magma is still not currently at shallow enough depths, in my opinion, to trigger an eruption in the near future, and besides, it is moving incredibly slowly. During world volcanic unrest periods, Unrest often undergoes multiple cycles of increasing and decreasing activity, and do remember that the vast majority of magmatic intrusions do not result in a volcanic eruption. However, what is a bit more likely are for more magnitude 3 and possibly even magnitude 4 quakes to strike if overall volcanic seismic activity remains high. Stay tuned for more updates. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, Shmishel Ezim, for supporting my work.